Hello everyone, this is Maggie with you from Animals Lebanon. I'm sitting here with the latest rescued lion cub who's still in a quarantine setup. As you can see, the cub is getting much, much better. We have been spending so much time with him to get him to trust again and feel comfortable and to get him at least to feel secure and safe. We've been spending hours with him on a daily basis, of course, in coordination with a lion specialist and a veterinarian who also specializes in lions. As you can see, he's much, much better. This is not the setup he will be in. This is a temporary setup. I repeat, this is a temporary setup until he goes to a sanctuary where there's grass, where there's other lions, and the environment he belongs to. But for now, he's in this quarantine because lion cubs, they can catch actually cat and dog diseases. So it's very important not to mix them. In fact, I don't know if you guys know, but we learned this the hard way years ago. We rescued the lion cubs and tigers and they all had parvo. They can catch dog parvo. So it's very important that these kind of animals are kept in isolation away from other animals. We were able to vaccinate him. He got his first vaccine. We actually had to get him something called a dead vaccine, not a live vaccine, which is another important information for big cats like lions and tigers. You can only vaccinate them with a dead vaccine. We were able to secure it from France and he got his first shot. As soon as he gets his second shot and all his paperwork is in order, he is going to the most beautiful place in South Africa. It's a sanctuary where Isam and Kelly already went to. I don't know if you remember the last two cubs we rescued in September. He will be joining us in South Africa. And now he's very curious, trying to see what's happening outside the window. As you see, he has lots of enrichment in his room. Lots of toys. It's important to keep it clean. And he gets 3 meals a day. I'm sure you're wondering, what does he eat? Basically, we're giving him raw meat with formula milk for babies. It's mixed together. He eats them 3 times a day. He gets 200 grams of meat and 200 ml of milk 3 times a day. And in between, he's getting chicken wings as snacks. And he's so kind, despite what went wrong with him. Sorry for my cough. Despite all the stuff that went wrong with him, he remained a very calm and gentle lion cub. He likes attention. And hopefully when he goes to the sanctuary, he'll get the attention of other cubs like him. What else? When we rescued him, he was full of ticks, sadly, which again proves that he was mistreated and kept in bad conditions. We were able to get rid of all the ticks. And I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone who donated for him and to tell you that we're still lacking donations. Sending him to a sanctuary is costly. I'm happy to share with you why. First of all, we need to construct a specific cage for him to travel in. It has to be according to IATA regulations, and the plane ticket by itself, because he will have to go via cargo, and it has to be like a pallet only reserved for him. So they don't charge only by the weight, they also charge by the volume, and this costs a lot. We also have to get a lion specialist to help us put him in the crate and all that. And until then, we've been spending lots of money on actually feeding him. He needs, like, as I mentioned, around 600 grams of meat per day, along with chicken wings and lots of pee pads, as you can see. Lots of toys, which get destroyed on a daily basis. And this is his favorite football. See, we have a Ronaldo. Hey little one, say hi to everyone. A lot of people care about you. So I will repeat, this is just a temporary setup for him. He's going to a sanctuary in South Africa. We're estimating the cost. Somebody's asking how much it costs. In total, 10,000. I forgot to mention possible legal fees, because it's very important to us that this doesn't happen again. We want to pursue the case legally. This has happened in September with the two line cubs that were trafficked at the Batroun checkpoint. And now with this guy, we haven't been able to identify the actual trafficking source. We do have information of a person who is actually doing most of these trafficked animals, whether it's lion cubs or tigers or parrots, gray parrots, they're endangered. So we want to pursue this legally, and as you know, legal fees are high. We have recently met a kind lawyer who's helping us, but of course everybody will have to make a living at the end of the day. So this is why we have high cost. People are asking about his name. He doesn't have officially a name yet, but there's an initial name, Mars, because he was rescued in the month, during the month of March. One of our supporters who had a lot of hand in actually making his rescue happen wanted to name him Mars. So you might keep this name. I think he's peeing. Yes, he peed and sat on it. Hey, little one. Yeah, Simba actually suit him. Somebody wrote Simba. But we have a lot. There are a lot of Simbas at the sanctuary where he's going to. So it's going to be a bit confusing. Which brings me to tell you about all the lions we rescued in the last years. We rescued over 21. And 6 of them are actually at the sanctuary where he is going to. His favorite toy is Stitch. And this is the 3rd Stitch I buy him. If anyone wants to donate anything for him, you guys can donate toys, because toys don't last. And I actually use them as a shield to pet him without getting harmed. I mean, I know he's nice and kind, but you should always be careful around wild animals. He is not a pet, he's a wild animal. And I always hope that we never have to put them in such setup, but unfortunately, they're being trafficked to the country and they have to be quarantined until they go to a sanctuary. He likes belly rubs. Come on, show everyone how you love it. Hey. As you can see, he's very calm because he's well fed, well cared for. It's very calm here in the setup. Nothing to stress him out. No visitors allowed. And I always would repeat this, lions are wild animals. You should never bring them as cubs to be pets. Yes, they might look cute as a cub, but soon enough, they'll be very dangerous and you will be actually harming them, because they require a lot of care, a lot of space, nutrition that doesn't exist here. We're actually having to get him vitamins from abroad to ensure he gets the right nutrition for his bones. They grow very quick and they need a lot of support for their system. Hey, little one. So once again, thank you for everyone who donated. And if you still wish to donate, you can DM us. You can donate items or meat. I mean, the meat, we're trying to get it on a daily basis to be fresh. But if you want to donate toward the cost of his food, or if you want to get him toys, they have to be soft with nothing for him to actually swallow, like buttons. And he will be leaving in a couple of weeks as soon as his paperwork are in order. We'll of course keep everyone posted about his travel to South Africa. What do you want? What do you want? As you can see, he's no longer scared like in the original video where they had taped his mouth. Thank you, Yasmina, for donating. Thank you, everyone. We're really grateful. Only with your support we can continue doing that. And our goal is to actually end all the trafficking of big cats to Lebanon. The law that we passed bans this completely. And there's also a decision that we worked with the ministry to ban the big cats. And I'm actually happy to say that this is the first time the person who did this stayed detained for a long while. The law is very strong here, and hopefully we can ban it completely from happening ever again. As you can see, he's very playful. He loves company. Hopefully soon he will be with the company of other lions. It took him a few days to get to this stage. He was very stressed out in the beginning and had shut down and always sleeping. Again, I will repeat, I know I've said it many times over the live. It's very important to note that this is just a temporary setup until he travels. He has to be in total quarantine. We cannot put him outdoors in grass because there might be cats and dogs that have been around the soil and he hasn't been vaccinated and did not have his mother's milk. So it's very important that he's isolated until he's fully vaccinated. In the wild, they don't have the viruses we have in the city, like the parvovirus of dogs or the pendocopenia of cats. They can catch this. So it's very important for him to be isolated. And that's why he's currently in a room where there hasn't been any animals around. And whoever goes to him, which is one person, has to be always in clean clothes, no shoes. It's a lot of care. They can deteriorate very quickly. He's estimated to be 3 to 4 months old. Someone is asking about his age. And he's very kind for for whatever trauma he has been through. I cared for 2 cubs a few months ago that came to us at younger age. They were 2 months old. And I was a bit worried that this guy is a bit older than them. But seeing his reaction with me, he's very kind. His name is now Mars for now. We're still haven't decided 100%, but one of our supporters wanted to name him Mars. He's so goofy and he's so funny, aren't you? Are you goofy? So again, this is the lion cub that you've seen in the horrific video a couple of weeks ago, where he was tortured with his mouth taped and somebody was showing him off to raise his followers on TikTok. He will be going to the sanctuary in South Africa. It's called the Drakenstein Lion Park. It's an accredited sanctuary, a safe one, that actually cares for the cubs and exists for the welfare of the lions. And they rescue lions from all over the world. We already sent 6 lions to them. Yes, I do. I am able to pet him, but I only do it if necessary, because at the end of the day, he's a wild animal and we like to respect that. Come. He's exactly like a cat. He wants to play. He has lots of toys. Can you show them your paw? Can we show your paw how beautiful it is? I mean, he's so super cute and we love caring for him, but it takes a lot of effort. We have to feed him timely and monitor his stool, help him pass the stool. Just like orphan kittens, they need to be stimulated to actually pass stool. And this is one of the challenges I'm facing daily. He's not aggressive. He doesn't mean to bite. But at the end of the day, he's a wild animal and he might do it just out of like playfulness. He loves belly rubs. The mother does this usually to help them, to help massage them. So we try as much as possible to do it. Hey, Goofy. Come. Come here. Come here, Goofy. Come here, Goofy. Yeah, I think I should call him Goofy. He is very goofy. And he's very kind. I mean, I've had lots of lions before. Not, I didn't have them, but we rescued a lot. And interacting with this guy, he's very gentle. He sleeps inside at night. He loves his bed and he can get sunlight. He's very curious about the sounds outside. I call him Hashur as well. He needs to know what's happening everywhere. And that's his favorite bed. I'm getting him his stuff from a cheap place called Arut because we need to change a lot of them every day because he tends to pee on them or destroy them. But it's very important to have enrichment because he's alone. In fact, cubs, they live with their mom until the age of 18 months and they usually many of them. So this guy needs his mom and his siblings and unfortunately he has neither of them. So the man who owned it, as far as we know, was detained and remained detained until last week. Our lawyer is following up on the case, of his case as well of the case of the other two cubs. And we're really working hard to ensure this trafficking stops. Yes, this is in Lebanon. We're located in Beirut. And this is a lion cub that we rescued a week ago. He was being tortured on TikTok. He was being dragged by a metal chain out of a box while there was disturbing music in the background. And from what we understand, that the goal of the person who was doing this is to raise his followers on TikTok, which is very sad. These animals are majestic. They belong in the wild. They're endangered. There's nothing fun or funny about having them. He is not dangerous in the sense of wanting to be dangerous, but yes, he could be dangerous to people because they're they're wild animals. As you can see, he has giant paws. He could probably harm while playing. Yes, we do. We are sending him to South Africa very soon. We're working on the paperwork and we're trying to rush it so he can be in the environment he needs to be in. Around other lions. He got his vaccines and we already got his CITES export and import. I don't know if you know what CITES means. CITES is the Convention on the International Trade of Endangered Species. It's an international convention and Lebanon is part of. This convention actually protects all endangered species like lions, tigers, chimpanzees, lots of the primates, because they're becoming endangered and it's very important to protect them. Of course, all of the lions that came to Lebanon did not have these import and export permits. So for sure now we are getting him those permits to ensure that his travel is 100% legal, and that's why it's taking time. I'm sure people wanna visit him, and I understand you, and it's a dream for everyone to be up close with a lion. But unfortunately, due to the trauma he's been through, we're not allowing any visitors. Our goal as Animals Lebanon is to protect animals and his animal welfare. And unfortunately, at the time, he's stressed when there are new smells or new people. So we're not allowing visitation for now. You can visit him at the sanctuary if you ever go to South Africa. Actually, they have a beautiful place. The lion sanctuary is called the Drakenstein Lion Park. And they have a beautiful setup for lions, lots of land, and visitors can see the lions without stressing them out. I do hope that Animals Lebanon can have the setup one day, a place where animals can be seen without being stressed. It's a huge structure, and it's usually done in a way to protect the animals. This is the difference between a sanctuary and a zoo. And a zoo is usually for the profit and for people to see animals. A sanctuary is for the welfare of animals without stressing them out. So it's built in a way where you can see the animal maybe over a bridge or something without having to stress him out. And I hope one day we can do that. Once we have the funding, we can build something where these animals can be there and you guys can come and see them. I think it's time for his nap soon. He gets his food 3 times a day. And he's gonna get his second meal now and go to sleep. Yes, zoos are. Thank you, Tilo, for adding. I'm really sorry for my cough. I've been sick since we got him and before, and my cough is still there. Hi, love. He's sleepy now. I just wanted to update everyone because I know a lot of people have been asking about him. He's doing much better. We're taking great care of him. If you want to donate toward him, please DM us or go online. If you want to send toys as well, they have to be new or at least not around animals, just to make sure we don't bring him any viruses. And once again, this is a temporary setup until he goes to the sanctuary. We will keep you posted of his news, and hopefully very, very soon you will see him on grass with other lions, living the life he deserves, the life of a majestic lion. Thank you everyone for your support. Hope you have a great Sunday.